one of pop music's superstars. Bryan, Ferry is back with his new album, Avalon, the first for 2 years. Since his band Roxy Music launched what was to become pop music's new wave, the band's distinctive style has influenced many of today's biggest selling groups. But it was always Bryan Ferry's sartorial and musical style which epitomised Roxy Music. In the last 10 years, Roxy Music have progressed from glitter through lounge lizard white tuxedo and black bow ties, and the while Bryan Ferry was rarely out of the gossip columns. The miner's son from Durham became the favourite of the jet set, always, it seemed, accompanied by beautiful companions. Then just a year ago, ironically after Roxy Music's first number one hit single, Jealous Guy, Bryan Ferry dropped out of sight, tired of the high life and the publicity. Since then, he's been working on the new album, Avalon, which gave Roxy Music their recent hit single, More Than This.
In spite of the success of Roxy Music's recent hit single, More Than This, people in the pop business, like everyone else these days, are suffering from the effects of the recession. And in the increasingly competitive pop world, even superstars like Bryan Ferry feel they need to go on the road to promote their latest album.
So there it is then, the title track of the brand new Roxy Music album, Avalon, and delighted I am to be playing it as Bryan Ferry looks across the table from me. Bryan, how does it feel hearing the track again just now?
It sounds all right.
You're very happy?
Yeah, basically. I mean, we've spent a lot of time working on the album, and it's always a bit difficult when it's just finished. You're a bit close to it, really. And you don't get objective till like 6 months or so afterwards.
In the middle of a grueling European tour, we caught up with him in Glasgow.
When you've spent a year or so working on the record and getting it all just right, where you hope it is, you feel that you have to go out and tell people about it. Otherwise, it might kind of slip away and not be noticed.
You do appeal to people all across the board, but you are known to be the top person's pop person. Why is it that you so appeal to the glitterati, for the want of a better word?
Well, I'm not sure if I do, in fact, but I mean, obviously, when you make records for kind of 10 years, whatever it is, you hope that, as you say, it's going to appeal across the board, and you're going to touch all kinds of people. Mm. And even the heights of cafe society. I mean,
you've always been very conscious of the image, or you're reputed to be, you know, to have a stylish image, and that has clearly changed over the years, as everyone's must. Where is yours taking you next, do you think?
No idea. I mean, I never really look forward much further than next month, and I hate to plan things. Everything that's happened so far in my career has been fairly intuitive. You know, one thing has led to the next thing, and I never really know what the next record's going to sound like until I'm actually in the studio and it just sort of starts to happen, you know. You make obvious, vague plans, you do sketches for songs and try and build up some idea of what you're going to do. But if I knew exactly what I was going to do all the time and what style I was going to pursue next week, I'd get pretty bored with it. Probably wouldn't do it in the end.
Your art training clearly still means a lot to you, because of course you design the sleeves of your records. But how much in private life do you paint or draw?
None at all. I think if I did, it would dilute the kind of artistic urge, if you like. And so I do try to protect that by not doing too much. I mean, once a year, or whenever I make an album, I play being art director for a week, which is great fun to do. But I still have contacts with the art world, you know, a lot of friends who are sort of painters and designers and so on, contemporaries of mine who still work in that field. So I still feel very close to that world. I've always been interested in how things look, you know, whether it's automobile design through architecture and clothes and stuff, everything.
Well, how much do you think that pop music today reflects the art of the 80s, if you like, and the way people are moving?
Well, I think that, especially in the sort of 70s with punk music, there's a lot of very violent music, and these are very violent times that we live in, or can be. I'm sort of less drawn towards that, that kind of thing at the moment. I think when I started, I did a lot of fairly sort of fairly savage things, aggressive music. And now I think I'm going through a period of reflection, back to nature.
How do you actually improve upon yourself? I mean, what do you do to be better than the last album?
It's very difficult, that one too. Obviously, you do try to improve with every piece of work that you make. And in every department, you just try to make it a bit better. From the writing, from the production of the music in the studio, which is one thing you do, I think, generally improve, because it's like any craft. You kind of refine it and get to know how to do it. You know, it's like any kind of craftsman, you learn your trade over the years. What you have to try and not lose is the kind of youthful innocence and energy that goes with that.
A very relaxed Bryan Ferry talking to Mary Marquis.